I got a good fish hooked up here. Got three night crawlers out. Oh, it's a big one. It's a big fish. Got 14 pound super line. I got her. Oh, this is a really, really heavy fish. Feels like another nice one. Another nice largemouth. And they just keep getting better. Real nice smallmouth. That's a heck of a channel cat. Real fat fish. Boy, it's really bulldogging. Last night I was out here catfishing and I caught a 41 and a half inch shovel head on about the same rig I've got out right now. I've just got smaller hooks on it. Nothing big. Try to get a little line on it. Boy, it's really fighting good. Look at that rod. This is a big, big fish. Been catching some real nice channels and some nice shovel heads, so hard saying what this is. It's about 1:20 in the morning right now. Water's been cooling down. We've been having a lot of cool nights and the fish are really starting to feed good. Out there it's just bulldogging. I can't really put a lot of pressure on it. It's actually one of my bass rigs. It's right below me. Feels like I'm pulling up 90 pounds. Hear them jumping out there. Fish have been real active all night. And I was just commenting how everything has quieted down, it seemed like. Had a rod out with liver and it started getting a run, and then this one took off with the night crawlers. Gotta take your time with them. Oh. Every time I'm gaining a little bit of line, it's pulling it out. When you're using this lighter line, you just want to make sure you leave your drag a little bit loose so that when it wants to make those explosive runs, it can. I still have no idea what we got here. Try to get some line on it now. Boy, it feels like a really heavy fish. Still haven't seen it yet. Oh. Don't want to pressure it too much and break off. Get into these battles, you just got to take your time with them. Feather that drag a little bit when you're trying to get some line, but if you feel them wanting to go at all, just let them go. There it goes. Pick it up. Oh my God, dude. I just have no idea what I have on here, but this is gonna be a really, really big fish. I'm feathering it too, man. When you get into a battle like this, some of the biggest mistakes I've made is you get impatient because you want to see the fish so bad, but you just got to stick with it and have patience. And hopefully everything holds. Oh boy. Just shaking its head. What do we have? Oh, look at it. It's a big shovel head. another big shovel head. Oh no, don't go under there. That was close. Just about went right around that pier. Caught a 41 and a half inch last night. And this one definitely looks like it has the potential to be that big at least. The cameraman just told me we're going on 8 minutes now on this fight. Getting her close. She's wore out. I got her. Oh, this is a really, really heavy fish. Two little hooks. I'm talking like a size 6 hook. And that fish got the second hook. And look at that. Just barely hooked. Look at that. That monstrous fish. Beautiful fish. Just beautiful. Get a good measurement on her. It's a 41 inch fish. Last time I caught a 41 and a half, but this fish is much fatter than last night's fish. Get a weight on her. We're gonna call it it says 29 to 30. Real close to 30 pounds. What a fish. What a battle. Well over 8 minutes. Close to a 10 minute battle. This beautiful shovel head. 30 pound fish, 41 inch. One more good shot ever. I'm gonna take and turn her back. Number two. Okay. Just wanna hold these big fish up. She put up a really good battle. She'll be good to go. Just hold her for a minute. Let her get her bearings. There she is. Look at that. Beautiful fish. Just make sure we hold her. She'll get strong enough and just actually pull away. You know then they're good to go. There she goes. Look at that beast. What a fish. And I just caught a 41 inch, 30 pound shovel head on it. I rigged this as I just take, ooh. Rods in the Dirt, new website. Come and check us out, rodsinthedirt.com.